Hi, friends.
Welcome back.
What's up, Miss Hoglin?
Oh, I just feeling a little silly.
Yep. Me too. But, you know, it'll make this lesson interesting.
It will.
We just had something funny happen. So we're going to stop and think and take a deep breath and come down from the five we're at on the feelings thermometer with silliness.
Yes.
Has that ever happened to you, friends, where you get really silly? I bet you can guess our zone. I bet they could. Let's check in with our zones, friends. How are you feeling today? What are your emotions doing? What is your body doing? What is your brain thinking? My brain right now is deep breaths, Mrs. Wally, focus. Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Lots of deep breathing.
Mr. Kevin, what zone are you in today?
Well, let's see here. Let's see if I can find the right camera angle. Yeah, I'm in a good zone. I guess it's green.
Or a little yellow.
A little yellow.
Miss Osler?
My brain is in the yellow zone, just kind of anxious about nothing but everything all at the same time, which is funny how that can happen.
Yep.
My body's in the blue zone because I'm just tired and I'm kind of having some allergy stuff going on.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I'm right. You?
My brain and body are in the green zone. No, that was not what I meant to say.
I was going to say.
My brain and emotions are in the green zone.
Okay.
My body's most definitely in the blue zone.
Yes.
I'm going to go home and take a nap when we're done.
I think that's a good idea.
I woke up at 2:30 this morning and couldn't go back to sleep.
Oh, no.
So I think I'm going to go home, take a nap, and then wake up and finish my work later.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, so, and I'm making really silly mistakes because of it. Because I'm just tired. That happens.
That's when we need to recognize that you're not being as efficient or productive. So you just stop, take your nap, and then come back to it.
And then you get it done.
Solve that problem.
All right. Let's move on with our lesson today.
Yeah, so today and every day we agree when we come together to
show respect, make good decisions, solve problems.
Just like Mrs. Wally is going to solve her problem by
when I get home today, I'm going to take a nap. But for now, I'm going to focus and we are going to show some respect to the indigenous people of our land here in Pacific Northwest.
I'm going to invite you to look out your window. Look at the sky and the trees. Your surroundings. Recognize that our physical space stands on the unceded land of the Coast Salish people. We acknowledge the Coast Salish community, their elders, both past and present, as well as future generations. We make this acknowledgement as part of our work to dismantle the ongoing legacies of settler colonialism and white supremacy.
So that's awesome. What does unceded mean?
Yes, the word unceded. So if I cede something to you, I give it to you willingly.
So it's like a gift.
Like a gift.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
so un, I mean, it's not.
It's not. Not given willingly, like a gift.
So like someone stole it from you or took it from you.
Yes.
So that means someone came here and took the land from the indigenous people and took it away from them.
Yes, and claimed it as their own.
And that's why we're here now, living on this land.
Yes.
Because people before us took it from them.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't feel very good.
It doesn't. But it's important for us to acknowledge and recognize that...
Even as first graders.
Mm-hmm, that this did happen.
Mm-hmm. We can't fix it now. We can't go back and change it.
No.
But we can do things moving forward that show respect.
And we can think about when we're talking about history and what has happened in our country's history and think about whose perspective it is that we're hearing from, whose story is being
told. And make sure we're hearing all the stories.
Yes.
Not just one perspective. It's important to hear all the perspectives so that we can understand what happened better.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That makes sense.
Yeah. So that's what we're going to do here at TV Classroom is keep learning and keep asking questions.
I think it's great.
Yeah. So let's look at our scientific process.
Oh, our lovely, almost like a wheel almost.
Yeah.
It's like a life cycle.
It reminds me of like gears.
Yeah, all going
where
together.
There's lots of different.
And they all connect and you can go in between each one. It's pretty cool. We do a lot of making observations. We've done that. And the scientist we're talking about today does a lot of making observations because they can't actually go to the place that they observe.
Oh, interesting.
So they have to ask a lot of questions, and they share with each other the data and ideas that they come up with when they observe. and they read a lot about what other people have discovered.
Oh, yes. And then they use that to come up with an explanation, mm-hmm. gather more data, interpret their observations.
And, like, test theories and hypotheses out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's when we think about what we thought we knew, and we revise our thinking.
Mm-hmm. And then, once we come up with a good solution that has backed by data, then we can kind of, like, answer our question. Mm-hmm. But then when we answer our question and solve a problem, guess what? Another question comes up or another problem pops up that we didn't think about.
More
so
questions.
Then we have to go back and start it again. Mm-hmm. And science just goes around and around and around, mm-hmm. and you just keep doing it. It's pretty great.
It is. Are you ready for our phenomena
yes.
today?
Yes.
While you're doing the reconfiguration, mm-hmm. I'll say phenomena.
Phenomena. This is a cool one. I haven't seen this one. Ooh, I'm excited.
Okay.
Are
you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go.
What's happening here? Miss Austin, you're going to have to explain this to me.
So the question that goes with this phenomena is, what's moving?
I think it's the camera.
You think it's the camera?
Mm-hmm.
I noticed that it just got to nighttime or dark.
Mm-hmm.
And then when they're upside down, or we're upside down, it's daytime again.
Right, and it doesn't happen that quickly.
No. See, the lights go on inside.
It's definitely in a time lapse.
Yes.
So it's happening very quick.
Yes.
I don't know. Does it tell us what's moving?
Not really.
Mr. Kevin?
So my wondering is what's the time period? Is this one day?
I'm assuming yes.
24
hours? It says, who moves, the sky or us?
Hmm.
So who's doing the moving? When we look at the sky, and it goes from daytime to nighttime, mm-hmm. is it the sky that moves over us?
I just
or
thought
is
of
it us that moves?
The term, the sun is setting.
But is the sun setting,
is the sun
or
moving?
Are we moving? Oh, those mm-hmm. are some things you could write down in your science notebook.
Yeah.
Those are good questions to mm-hmm. put in the I wonder part mm-hmm. of your inquiry chart.
Your inquiry chart. And you could
yes.
think about what you think you know now.
I do think that the camera's moving here to show the effect of it.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, because I don't know how you would get the camera to stay still.
Yeah, I don't.
And then have that move around. But I understand what the camera's trying to show.
Yes.
The camera is showing
the rotation,
of the Earth.
In one day, I think, to answer mm-hmm. Mr. Kevin's.
Pretty interesting, isn't it?
24 hours, yeah.
Okay, so let's see if Miss Oslin can do this all on her own. I think she can.
She's a pro now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. End show.
Start it again. Restarting it. I got to restart it.
There you go. Now you're good. That's where it gets tricky for you. You go up here and you duplicate and then it yeah.
messes with
my settings.
You just
hit the three dots.
Okay, three dots.
Mm-hmm.
We're learning.
Right. We learn every day.
So then our essential question, how does the sky impact the Earth?
Hmm.
How does what's happening
impact what's happening here?
Yeah.
And what's rotating? Is the sky rotating or are we rotating? Thinking back to that input chart mm-hmm. we did last time, I think we have the answer.
Yep.
Did the sun and the moon, well, the moon moves.
The moon moves.
But it moves with the Earth.
Right. Gravity.
Mm-hmm. So who is spinning, the sky or the people in the Earth and the globe? It's us.
It's us.
We spin. But we can't feel it. Just like when you're in an airplane, you can't mm-hmm. feel it moving.
Yeah.
Or riding in a car, you don't
yep.
really know you're moving.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing.
So first graders, you are going to make the good decision. To get your materials out, you should have your inquiry chart in front of you.
Writing
you
it down.
Thinking about what you think you know, what questions you have as we go through.
What you want to learn.
What you want to learn.
Mm-hmm. There's lots to learn about the sky.
There is. And we're going to learn more today as
we get ready for our new big science word.
Mr. Kevin, I think that was the best one you've done.
Yes.
Nice job, Mr. Kevin. Way to go.
We learned that an astronomer is a scientist who studies the universe beyond the Earth.
And today in our input chart, we're going to learn how we know what the word means by looking at the word.
Ooh.
Are you ready, first graders?
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, I didn't give you a chance to make a prediction. I just told you our new word and what my prediction is. The word solar.
Like a solar panel has sun beating on it.
Yep, that's what I was thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Solar means of, having to do with, or coming from the sun.
So solar energy means energy that comes from the sun.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What else do we use the word solar for? Mr. Kevin?
Well, I was just going to say, you know, my sister sold her car.
Mr. Kevin, that sold.
Sold her.
Not solar.
Solar eclipse.
Ooh, it's an eclipse that has to do with the sun.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to learn about eclipses. What about a solar battery?
Oh.
A battery charged by the sun.
Mm-hmm. And then solar panels, like you said.
Mm-hmm.
They get their energy from the sun.
Mm-hmm.
Solar panels collect energy from the sun.
It has to do with the sun.
There you go.
It's the energy from it.
Yep.
The sun is a very powerful energy source. So powerful it can burn our skin, which is why it's really important to wear sunblock or sunscreen.
Mm-hmm.
Sunblock is a natural barrier. Sunscreen is a chemical barrier that you can put on your skin.
There we go.
Just my little two cents there about wearing sunscreen every single day, friends.
Mm-hmm. I do.
I did not know the difference between sunblock and sunscreen until
so
now.
So sunblock actually blocks the rays of the sun from being able to penetrate your skin. And sunscreen is a chemical reaction that happens on your skin that stops the rays from burning you.
Wow.
I only know this because of my niece Hayden. She has albinism, which means she doesn't have any natural protection from the sun at all. So if she goes out within 5 minutes, she gets sunburned.
Mm.
So before she leaves her house, she has to put sunblock on. They use sunblock, and she wears lots of sunblocking clothing to keep her skin safe. Yep.
We're also going to learn about a telescope.
We are. I'm so excited. What's a telescope?
What is a telescope?
Tele, like I think a phone. Telephone.
That's what I was thinking, exactly.
But it's a telescope.
Yeah.
Telephone, telescope. So it wouldn't be a telephone because a telephone's a telephone.
Yep.
So tele.
Tele must
mean to look? No, because you don't look at a phone.
Nope.
What is it, Ms. Oslin?
It's an instrument that makes distant objects appear larger.
Oh, a scope. So tele must mean an instrument? That a scope is to make things look closer or further away? Yes, yeah. Mr. Kevin?
So from the root word, the tele
is
long. Distance.
Long. See, this is why we have Mr. Kevin.
So with a telephone, I can talk to someone. For
a long way away. And a telescope.
I can see things.
From a long way. Microscope. Micro means close up or small.
Oh.
A microscope is a scope that lets me see really tiny things. A telescope lets me see things that are really far away.
Okay.
Aha!
That's why it's helpful to know the roots of words, isn't it?
I know. We've got to get better at that, Ms. Oslin. Thanks, Mr. Kevin. Or maybe that can be one of Mr. Kevin's jobs.
Yeah.
He seems to know it really well.
He does.
You may have just got yourself a job, Mr. Kevin.
The root word, rooter, outer?
That's right. Our root word detective.
There we go.
Okay.
Astronomers use telescopes to look at stars.
Stars are definitely a long ways away.
They are.
They also look at other things. We're going to learn about
they
that,
do.
Too.
Oh, an astronomer boogaloo written by Sarah Coddington and Stephanie Wright.
Here we go.
I'm an astronomer, and I'm here to say I study patterns in the sky every day. Sometimes I use telescopes or satellites in the sky, but usually I observe patterns with my eyes. Moon, planets, constellations too, doing the astronomer boogaloo. Orbiting the Earth, the moon has phases, waxing and waning, lit by the sun's blazes. New moon to crescent, the full moon looks larger, 28 days and the cycle starts over. Moon, planets, constellations too, doing the astronomer boogaloo.
So we're going to be astronomers today.
Yeah, we're actually going to learn what an astronomer is and all of the things about them, like the description of what they are, the tools they use,
yes,
the patterns they observe, not all of them, just some of them. Mm-hmm. And predictions that they make, because we know scientists make predictions.
All right.
So today, we are going to be doing a chart all about an astronomer. Now, astro, not the N, just the astro, means space.
Space.
And makes this word a noun, and it means a person who does. So it's a person who studies space, astronomer.
Nice. See? Root words.
Root words.
Yeah, you're very good at root words, Mrs. Oslin and Mrs. Wally.
Well, I learned that from our lovely GLAD unit.
Mm-hmm.
But I did learn it, and I had to write it down so I could remember it. So we're first going to talk about the description. And Miss Oslin, I'm just going to let you describe it, and I'm going to draw it as you describe it.
Okay. An astronomer is a scientist who studies space.
Oh.
And they observe patterns. Patterns are things that are repeating over, and they're predictable. They also make predictions. They study things like comets, planets, asteroids.
I'm going to draw some of this. A comet?
Yeah.
Planets. Here's the sun. And the things orbiting around. Here's Earth. We're a planet.
Asteroids.
Ooh, asteroids. Those are big things that can bang into things.
And constellations.
Ooh, this is a fun one.
Constellations are...
What are those?
Stars that form patterns.
Right. So, and they don't actually make the lines. We connect. It's like playing connect the dots.
Yep.
Isn't that cool? That's a constellation. Everyone say it?
Constellation.
Yeah.
I like to go out and look and try to find the constellations, like the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper.
Oh, it's really fun. I got to finish drawing my astronomer here.
Your scientist who studies space and the universe beyond
now,
our Earth.
Miss Oslin.
Yes.
You know, it's really interesting.
What?
Is that this astronomer here is using a tool. Did you know that astronomers use different tools to help them study this place that's far, far away?
Because they can't go there.
They can't go there.
So they have to use a...
They have to use tools. Different kinds of tools.
Yes.
Hang on, I'm going to write. Okay. Oh, it's supposed to be purple. Good thing I wrote a note to myself.
That was a good strategy.
Thanks. Tools.
So we just learned that a telescope is a tool that scientists, astronomers use to see things far away.
So they look in here and it magnifies the things far away and then they can see it.
Makes it look larger.
They also use satellites.
Satellites are things that orbit in space.
So they orbit around the Earth, and they take pictures and send signals and help us understand the things that are up there in space.
They gather a lot of data. There's also a place called an observatory.
Oh, and we have a few here in Washington. There's one over in Ellensburg. There's one in Seattle. There's one on Bainbridge Island. And it's like a really big, giant telescope, and at night you can open the roof and it's got this really high powered telescope that lets you see things really clearly in space.
It's called an observatory. It helps you observe.
Observatory. And we had a satellite. Now the moon is also a satellite.
Ooh, that's a fun fact.
Is not a tool. It's just a natural satellite of Earth. So it just naturally orbits around Earth.
So a satellite is something that orbits something else.
Now, we've talked a little bit about patterns.
Ooh, yeah, patterns. Patterns that astronomers observe. Some of the things that are predictable and repeating are like the moon phases, like we heard in our boogaloo.
Yeah, waxing and waning. And this is the moon going around the Earth, orbiting. Now, we don't have that many moons. This is a different day every day, the moon going around in a whole month. What else do they
observe? That's why the moon looks different, right? You can have a full moon. You can have a crescent moon.
You can have a waxing or a waning.
Other things that or patterns that astronomers observe are the comet's path.
Well, there's lots of them. So I put comet paths.
Comet paths.
Because they make lots of paths since there's lots of different comets.
Same with asteroids. Asteroid paths.
Yes.
Where are they going?
And that's important, to know where asteroids are going and comets are going. Why is that important, Ms. Aslan?
Because if they're going to come into the Earth's atmosphere, we need to know.
Yeah, and if an asteroid, a big asteroid, is going to hit, we need to know so we can prepare the people on Earth because it will cause some damage. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Predictions.
Scientists make so many predictions. So I wonder what kind of predictions they make.
Based on what they observe using their tools, they can predict the position of planets. Where are planets?
Because we don't have anything up there that can like take a picture of the whole solar system and tell us where every planet is.
Oh, it's too big.
It's too big. So we have to make a prediction. Mm-hmm. All of the charts you see are predictions based off of data and observations that scientists have made. Okay,
and
what else?
They're also open to changing their thinking as they gather new information. Meteorite showers.
Oh, they're my favorite. Ooh. Have you ever seen a meteorite shower, Ms. Hassan?
I have.
I have too. The Perseid meteorite shower in the summertime. We go up to Mom's cabin and it looks like these stars are just like shooting all over the sky. It's
very
really
neat.
Beautiful.
And the lunar eclipse.
I put solar on here as well.
Yes. Solar.
Solar. Oh, there's that word. Having to do with the sun.
So then lunar means,
if solar is sun, lunar must mean moon.
The moon. Kiss your brain, first graders.
Now, I have some interesting facts to share.
I love interesting facts.
It's one of my favorite things about nonfiction text is when they have interesting facts that I didn't know. Interesting. I had to think about that. Stop and think, Mrs. Wally. Interesting facts. The solar system. Do you know how long ago it was formed?
I can't even wrap my brain around.
It's so big. Was formed around, they don't know exactly, but it's a guess, it's an estimate, 4.6 billion years. I'm going to write that number out. Are you ready? A go. So, we have...
It was on a Tuesday.
We have hundreds, we have thousands, we have millions,
Ooh, and then
we have billions. That's a very big number.
It is.
4,600,000,000 years ago.
So solar system. So that's the system having to do with the
sun.
Sun.
The system that goes around the sun. That's why it's called the solar system. It is the system up in space that has to do with the sun. There are other systems around there. And some of them are solar too. They have to do with the sun. We just haven't found them yet. And then also, I thought this was really cool. We've been to the moon. Not you and I. I wish we had been
to
the moon.
We went to the moon.
But they have had people go up to the moon. NASA had all these programs sending people to the moon. And they made footprints when they landed on the moon. And did you know that those footprints are there forever? Do you know why?
No. Does it have to do with gravity?
Nope. Because there's no wind on the moon.
There's
no weather on the moon. So there's nothing to blow it away or wash it away. Unless someone else goes up there and dusts them away.
That's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
That is fun.
Isn't that interesting? So astronomers, they study all of these things to help us learn more about space. Because space is such an interesting thing, and not many people get to go there. Now, some people have gotten to go there, but not many. I am just writing this down so we can remember that they study comets, planets, asteroids, constellations, and even black holes.
Ooh, that's exciting.
Black holes are really interesting. Okay, friends. That's an astronomer.
Astro, space, person.
A space person.
Space person.
Not like a space person that lives in space, but a person who studies space.
Very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
So thinking about the patterns that an astronomer studies, the tools that they use, when you think about how does the sky impact the Earth?
Why are they studying all of these things? Thinking about solar and the sun and its energy. and the stars and the patterns that they make, mm-hmm. and the moon and its phases, mm-hmm. and the comets and the asteroids.
And the tilt of the Earth, the rotation.
They study all these things.
They do.
And they use really cool tools like telescopes and satellites and these really cool observatories. We're trying mm-hmm. to figure out a way to get into them, but we don't know if we'll be able to. Mm-hmm. But it would be cool if we did get to go there.
That would be neat.
Mm-hmm. Or talk to a real astronaut. That would be cool,
that
too.
That would be really cool.
Astronauts are astronomers. They actually mm-hmm. get to go into space and study space.
It's like their lab.
Mm-hmm. Yep, on the International Space Station, they have a little lab, and they do all mm-hmm. sorts of experiments and observing. And mm-hmm. it's pretty neat.
So, first graders, mm-hmm. your job is to think about astronomers. Mm-hmm. And the question we want you to respond to is, how does an astronomer draw conclusions about their observations of the sky?
So what do they use to decide what they think they know?
Yeah.
Think about this chart and all the things you learned about an astronomer.
What you've learned on the other input chart, too, about yep. the tilt mm-hmm. of the Earth.
And the sun and the moon.
The seasons.
Mm-hmm. And the rotations. Mm-hmm. And you have to put it on Flipgrid.
Yes.
Now, first graders, no first graders have responded yet.
Not yet.
Mr. Kevin?
Okay, so I have a surprise for you, ladies.
Ooh.
A surprise?
We love yes. surprises.
I'm going to put you, just because you're such great teachers.
And I know what he's doing.
Are we going to
the
moon?
You are now on the
yes!
surface of the moon.
We are on the moon.
I want to make a footprint right there.
We get to go on the moon.
That's amazing.
Ms. Ozen, I think, Mr. Kevin, from now on for first grade, we should be on a planet or the moon.
We should.
We should go to different parts of the solar system.
Oh, that would be great.
It's a great
idea. Like, one day be on the sun, yes. and be on Saturn and Mars.
Perfect.
Very
okay,
cool.
I love it. What a great idea.
I know.
Okay, so we want to hear your ideas about, what was the question again, Mrs. Ozen? It went out of my brain.
How does an astronomer draw conclusions about their observations of the sky?
I got too excited about the moon.
I know.
So what are the things they use? What are the patterns they study? Mm-hmm. And what predictions do they make?
Yeah.
And how do they do that? Put it on Flipgrid or Mr. Kevin?
Well, first graders, just if you need to get a little help from an adult, that's fine. Mm-hmm. We want to see your email. So email us at tvclassroom@tacoma.k12.wa.us. Or you can send us something in the regular mail. Now, since Mrs. Ozlin and Mrs. Wally are on the moon right now, it may take an extra stamp. I'm not sure. But send it to TV Classroom, 601 South 8th Street, Tacoma, Washington, 98405.
Oh, Mr. Kevin,
thank you,
you
Mr.
make
Kevin.
Me laugh. All right, friends. Time for our affirmation.
Ooh, positive things we can say about ourselves.
I am strong. I don't know why.
Ah.
But I just feel like somebody needs to hear that today.
Yeah, I think I do.
Okay.
Here we go. Take a deep breath.
I am strong.
Excellent job today, first graders. We hope you have a great rest mm-hmm. of your day, and we look forward to seeing you back here next time in our TV classroom.
On the moon.
So, on the moon. Yeah, float out.
Bye, friends.
You gotta float
Ooh.
Out.
Ooh. Bye, friends. See you later.
Thank you. Rules. 1. You have 10 seconds to pick your crewmate. 2. A new timer will appear with an exercise for the crewmate you picked. 3. You will get 10 points for each correct crewmate and exercise you choose. 4. If you pick the imposter, you will lose all your points. 5. See how many points you can get. Good luck.